Military discipline is the unhesitating, unquestioned response to command. Every airman starts learning this discipline in basic training on the drill field. This film will deal with individual drill instruction without arms. The airmen in this film have received 2 to 4 weeks of basic military training. The first basic position is that of attention. To assume this position, bring the heels together smartly on the same line. Hold them as near each other as conformation of the body permits. The feet are placed at an angle of 45 degrees. Keep the knees straight without stiffness. Hold the hips level, body erect, and weight divided equally. The chest is lifted and arched. Shoulders are square and even. Let the arms hang straight down without stiffness. Thumbs along the seam of the trousers. Hold back of hands out. Fingers curled naturally. Thumbs resting along the first joint of the forefingers. Keep the head erect and squarely to the front. Keep the chin drawn in so that the axis of the head and neck is vertical. This position is only comfortable when the weight of the body rests equally on the heels and the balls of the feet. All rest positions are executed at the halt and at attention. First, there's parade rest. At the command, move the left foot smartly 12 inches to the left. Keep the legs straight so that the weight of the body rests equally on both feet. The hands are clasped behind the back with the arms hanging naturally. Palms will be to the rear, thumb and fingers of the left hand clasping the right, whose fingers are extended and joined. Do not place the hands in the small of the back. The arms should hang naturally, with no space showing between the arms and body. Remain silent and don't move. The at-ease position allows movement of the left foot. Motion is allowed, but silence is maintained. The rest position is similar. However, either foot can be moved and you need not stand still. Talking is permitted. To resume the position of attention from these positions, take the position of parade rest when the preparatory command is given. Then, snap to attention on the command of execution. Another rest command is given to troops in formation. This is fall out. Troops are permitted to leave ranks, but must remain in the immediate area. At the command fall in, troops return to their former position in ranks at attention. All facings are executed from the halt and in the cadence of quick time. To execute right face, slightly raise the left heel and the right toe. Face right, turning on the right heel, assisted by slight pressure on the ball of the left foot. Hold the left leg straight and place the left foot smartly beside the right foot. Left face is done in the same manner, except that you turn on the left heel and the ball of the right foot. To face to the rear, the command is about face. At the command, move the ball of the right foot to a position touching the ground 6 inches to the rear of and slightly to the left of the left heel. Keep the right leg straight without stiffness. Face to the rear, turning to the right on the left heel and the ball of the right foot. When this movement is properly executed, the feet will form a 45 degree angle with heels together. In facing about, don't swing the arms. Keep them in normal position of attention. When troops are not armed or arms are slung, the salute is given at the command, present arms. Raise the right hand smartly until the tip of the forefinger touches the lower part of the headdress and above and slightly to the right of the right eye. Hold the arm horizontal with the forearm inclined at a 45 degree angle. Thumb and fingers are extended and joined. Hold hand and wrist straight with palm down. Hold head and eyes at attention unless otherwise ordered. At the command, order arms, the salute is completed by dropping the hand in one motion to a normal position at the side. You may use the hand salute in individual military courtesy or in the ranks. In ranks, the hand salute is executed in 2 counts. When rendering an individual salute, turn head and eyes toward the person saluted and hold the salute until it is returned. Next, we'll take a look at steps and marching. When executed from a halt, all steps except right step begins with the left foot. Preparatory commands and commands of execution are given as the foot in the direction of the turn strikes the ground. For instance, here's a column left movement. The preparatory command and the command of execution are given as the left foot strikes the ground. Marching is in quick time. At the command forward march, step off smartly with the left foot. Continue to march with 30-inch steps, straight forward without stiffness or exaggeration of movements. Swing the arms easily in a natural arc, 6 inches straight to the front and 3 inches to the rear of the body without noticeable bending of the elbows. The command to halt is given as either foot strikes the ground. Execute the halt in two counts by advancing and planting the other foot and bringing up the rear foot. The facings to the right or left in marching are left flank and right flank. To face to the right or left in marching from a halt, turn to either flank on the ball of the right foot and at the same time step off with the left foot in a new direction. Shown in slow motion, here's a right flank movement while in march. The command of execution is given as the right foot hits the ground. Advance and pivot with the left foot and step off in the new direction on the right. Now in quick time, the left and right flank movements. Now, the execution of to the rear march. Again in slow motion, the command march is given as the right foot strikes the ground. Advance and plant the left foot, then turn about to the right on the balls of both feet and immediately step off on the left foot. In marching, you may get the command, change step, march. March is given as the right foot hits the ground. Advance and plant the left foot, then plant the toe of the right foot near the left heel and step off on the left foot. This movement is completed in one count. Individual leadership qualities usually begin to appear on the drill field. If you cannot follow, you cannot lead. A basic knowledge of drill is essential to you, the future leaders of the Air Force.